Imagine that you're managing multiple data collectors from different teams, and each data collector has its own configuration and pipeline. Every time you have to run a test or push out a new change, the process is time-consuming and can introduce a new risk. Even if you're the most experienced administrator, this process can quickly overwhelm you. What if there is a tool that can control and monitor all your data collectors from one central place? I'm Marie Cruz, a developer advocate here at Grafana Labs, and in this video, I'll show you how Grafana Fleet Management can help you manage your data collectors. To follow along in this learning journey video, you need to sign up for a Grafana Cloud account and start with our generous free forever plan. If you're already using Grafana Cloud, you need to make sure that you have admin privileges to access fleet management. You also need to have the latest version of Grafana Alloy installed. With that said, let's learn what Grafana Fleet Management is and how it can help you. Fleet management is a feature of Grafana Cloud that gives you a single dashboard where you can see and monitor all your data collectors. It's similar to how Kubernetes manages pods. You can think of a collector like a pod that is running on different machines. And fleet management acts as this control plane where you can view the status and health of your collectors, assign configuration changes, and remotely configure them. With fleet management, you don't have to worry about complex scripts and time-consuming change management processes. Since you can view the status of all your data collectors at once, you can troubleshoot issues quickly. Finally, fleet management gives you control over your observability data. You can turn different data streams on and off as and when you need them to optimize and reduce data overload. When you install Grafana Alloy, it might already be configured for Grafana Fleet Management, but it's not always the case. Especially if you were using an old version of Alloy or you installed it without enabling remote configuration for fleet management. In the next milestone, I'll show you how you can check if your Alloy data collectors are configured for Grafana Fleet Management. Checking if an Alloy collector is registered with Fleet Management is very simple. All you have to do is open the Grafana menu, navigate to Connections, Collector, and go to Fleet Management. The Inventory tab will display all registered collectors. If your Alloy data collector is not here, that means it's not been configured for Fleet Management. Adding an existing Alloy collector is quite simple. First, you need to make sure that you have an API token with the correct permissions, and then you need to update your Alloy configuration file to include a remote configuration block. Let's look at how we can do that in the next milestones. To begin the onboarding process, you must authorize Fleet Management to access your data collector via an API token. Within Grafana Cloud, we can do that. So open your Grafana menu, navigate to Connections again, Collector, but this time go to Configure. We're going to use the tool on this page to create a new API token. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give a token name. So let's say Marie Fleet Token. I'll just set up an expiration date as well. And then we're going to click Create Token button. The generated token comes with a predefined scope called Set Alloy Data Right. This includes scopes for reading configuration management in fleet management and also writing telemetry to Grafana Cloud databases. I'm going to copy this token here and save it in a secure file. Definitely make a note of this token because you're going to need this for the next milestone. To enroll your Alloy collector to fleet management, you need to add a remote CFG or remote configuration block to your Alloy configuration file. The remote CFG block is a configuration section inside Grafana Alloy that tells Alloy how to connect to fleet management to receive remote configuration updates. Let's copy the example configuration here and add it to the end of our Alloy configuration file. Now we need to update the URL, username, and password. You can find the base URL in the Grafana Cloud Fleet Management user interface. Let's go back to Grafana and go to Collector and go back to Fleet Management. Now I'm going to click the API tab. Within the API tab, you should see the URL in the base URL section. Let's copy that and paste that into our configuration file. Next, let's copy the instance ID and add that as our username. Finally, let's add the API token from the previous milestone and add that as our password. I'll use the default ID for my collector and also keep the attributes as is. But if you wanted to add more key value pairs to describe your collector, feel free to update the attributes key. Now, fleet management comes with a set of auto configuration pipelines that provide self-monitoring telemetry to check the health and status of your data collectors. To use these self-monitoring pipelines, you need to set a couple of environment variables. The configuration of these environment variables depends on your operating system. My Alloy configuration file is located in this spot, so let me go ahead and open that file. And the first environment variable that we need to set is the Grafana Cloud Remote Write API key. Now, this variable should match the Grafana Cloud access token that we created for fleet management. So I'm just going to copy the same token and add that here. The next variable is the Grafana Cloud Fleet Management Log Path. Now, this tells Alloy where to write logs for its fleet management integration. I'm going to set it to my Alloy log file, which can be found in this spot. Let's save the changes and restart our Grafana Alloy service. Now, if I go back to fleet management, I can see that the Alloy collector that I registered is now listed. I can also go to my local Alloy, and if I click the remote configuration tab, I can see that there's now two pipelines for the self-monitoring metrics as well as for the self-monitoring logs. Now, in the next milestone, we'll look at how we can check the health status of our collector from the fleet management UI. Grafana Fleet Management provides a health status indicator so you can see at a glance if your collectors are healthy. You can find a collector's health status in the status column. My Alloy collector has a green status, meaning that it's functioning properly and it doesn't have any errors. But if you have multiple Alloy collectors, then it can also have other status. Some status could be yellow, which means that it's potentially unhealthy and has an active non-critical alert, or it hasn't collected any metrics for whatever the time duration. The status could also be red, meaning that the collector has an active and critical alert, or the status could also be gray, which means that it hasn't collected any data at all. To look at the health of your data collectors in a much more detail, we need to look at the dashboards that fleet management provides out of the box. Let's look at how we can do that in the next milestone. To see the different out-of-the-box dashboards that fleet management provides, we need to click our collector. And within the health tab, you can see a collection of different dashboards. We'll go through them one by one. So the first dashboard is the collector dashboards, which displays metrics from all the components from the collector, such as the number of running components, their overall component health, and the health of each of these components. The resources dashboard shows the metrics from the collector's usage, such as the CPU and memory usage. Next, we have the Prometheus components dashboard. And this dashboard shows the metrics from the Prometheus components, such as the Prometheus.scrape as well as the Prometheus.remote-write component. Okay, now imagine that there is an issue in one of your components. What if you want to troubleshoot your collectors if there are any issues? Fleet management also collects internal logs that you can use. Let's look at how you can use these logs in the final milestone. Apart from the self-monitoring metrics pipeline, fleet management also configures a self-monitoring logs that collect internal logs about your data collectors. To view the logs, let's go to the Logs tab. You can refer to the different log messages here, which can help you diagnose any collector errors. You can also explore the logs by clicking the Explore Logs button, and this should take you to the Grafana Logs drill down. From here, you can change the time range, you can click Show Logs, and you can filter the error message by clicking the error legend here. And that is it for today's learning journey. You learn what fleet management is about and how you can add your Alloy data collector to fleet management. You also looked at the different out-of-the-box dashboards and internal logs that fleet management provides to help you understand the health of your collectors and troubleshoot any issues. If you enjoy this type of learning, head over to grafana.com/docs/learningjourneys for other Grafana learning journeys. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you at the next one.